Top Democrat scandal explodes, he made taxpayers pay $220,000 to hide. Another day, another scandal. All I can say is the 2018 elections can't come fast enough. Democrat after Democrat is being exposed. These men are taking advantage of women on their staff. It's not a huge surprise that so-called male feminists turn out to be abusers of women. Already numerous politicians have left office in disgrace. Men like Al Franken and John Conyers were caught with their pants down. In some cases, that was literal. But they are not the last. Now we are learning of another Democrat who was caught. Not only did he harass women, but it cost US $220,000. Let the outrage commence. From Joe for America. With Al Franken and John Conyers gone from public office for sexual abuse, is Democrat Representative Alcee Hastings next? On Friday, it was released that the Treasury Department paid $220,000 to settle a lawsuit brought by a former congressional staffer alleging sexual harassment by Hastings. The Florida congressman claims he knew nothing about the payout, but did not deny the allegations. According to Roll Call, which cited documents related to the case, Winston Packer alleged that Hastings touched her inappropriately and made unwanted sexual advances. On one occasion, Packer said Hastings asked her what kind of underwear she was wearing. The pattern has been, one allegation first, then women come out of the woodwork, and then resignation. Should we be surprised at Congressman Hastings' actions with his previous track record? He was impeached in 1988 for perjury and bribery by the U.S. House, but they still allowed him to become a congressman only 5 years later. It's sick enough that these politicians were abusing women. But to learn they use taxpayer dollars to cover it up? Is there anything these hacks won't do? How could the government allow this to happen? They forked over $220,000 to deal with this man. You'd think a pink slip would have been attached. But no, once again the swamp protected its own. It's about time we rejected every last corrupt politician. All of them must go, from local to federal government. We did not elect people so they could harass their staff. Anyone proven to harass, abuse, or harm people must be removed. What do you think of yet another liberal being exposed? How many more do you think are out there? Be sure to let us know.